40th Ruby Jubilee of the Pine City Colleges, or formerly Pine City Doctors Hospital School of Nursing. Starting off with Miss Victoria Ambukai, also known as Kay Nightingale, now Mrs. Pinget, Miss Victoria Calpito, now Mrs. Abello. She's married to Mr. Herme Abello in 1980 and blessed with 3 children and 4 grandchildren. Next is Miss Elizabeth Seva. She previously worked as a clinical instructor in the University of the Cordilleras and Pine City Colleges. She has 2 sons and 8 grandchildren, presently doing portraits and caricatures. And her business name is Rose Petals Arts. Next is Miss Editha Dahanay, now Mrs. Fernandez. Married to Engineer Gil Fernandez and blessed with 3 girls. She retired last 2016 as Provincial Population Program Officer for 34 years. Next is Miss Eleanor Damata, now Mrs. Bakayan. She is currently residing in Victorville, California, registered nurse at St. Mary Medical Center, Apple Valley, California, and blessed with 2 children. Next is Ms. Jovita Estepa, now Mrs. Pajarillo. Presently, she is working in Baguio General Hospital and Medical Center as an assistant chief nurse at NEC. Next is Ms. Josie Fabiculana, now Mrs. Tomasi. She retired as head nurse in Santo Niño Hospital, Felix Mining Corporation, and currently residing in Baguio City. Next is Mr. Danilo Ines. Sir Danny is currently working as a nurse safety officer or administrator in Condril AB in Libya since 1975. Next is Ms. Marilyn Luna, now Mrs. Gomez. There you go. She is retired at 55 years old and worked overseas and currently active in missionary works. All right, we have Miss Angelita Martin, now Mrs. Tanhueco, married to Mr. Alexander Tanhueco and blessed with 3 children and 2 grandchildren, presently residing in Angeles City and owns a family business. We have Mr. Alex Martin. He is married to a Kabampangan, blessed with 3 children and 4 grandchildren, and retired nurse for 22 years in Saudi Arabia. I overtook the video, sorry, but our next is Miss Maryline Luna. There you go. Also, now Mrs. Gomez. Next is Miss Gloria Mendoza. Now Mrs. De La Rama. Married to Mr. Mac De La Rama. Or sorry, next is Rodora, Maria Rodora Mamaison. Now Mrs. Soriano, also known as Vicky, worked in Prince Sultan Military Medical City in Riyadh, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for 19 years and 2 years in King Khalid International Airport Hospital. And she's now retired and currently residing in Baguio City and blessed with 3 children. There you go. And here is Miss Gloria Mendoza. There you go. Where's Miss Gloria? There you go. Now Mrs. De La Rama, and she is married to Mr. Mac De La Rama, blessed with 2 sons, retired from overseas and presently residing in Baguio City. Next is Miss Emerita Pardo, now Mrs. Somera. She's employed at the regional health unit as a public health nurse in Sison, Pangasinan from 1987 up to the present. Next is Miss Marlene Perlas. Now, Mrs. Bringas, or Mrs. Bringas, working as a municipal health nurse at LGU Bukay Abra. We also have Miss Yolanda Kiambao, now Mrs. Tan, residing in Baguio, PDN at SLU Hospital in 1983. ICU nurse at Philippine Heart Center from 1984 to 1986. Got married in 1987 and blessed with 4 kids, 1 grandson, and became a homemaker. Next is Ms. Teresita Serio, now Mrs. Carantes. She is the municipal health nurse in Health Nurse 2 in Itogon, Benguet, for 32 years, lives in Poblacion, Itogon, Benguet, and has 5 daughters and 2 grandchildren. We have Miss Crispina Soriano, now Mrs. Fabia, married to attorney Jose Fabia, connected with the commission audit, blessed with 5 daughters and managing a family business. We also have Miss Gloria Tabarejos, now Mrs. Kaasi. She is a retired as an OFW, has 5 children, and residing now in Bolinao, Pangasinan. Next is Miss Teresita Tagtag. Now, Mrs. Kilik. She's working in United Kingdom and blessed with 2 children. We also have Miss Lolita Tolentino. Miss Lolita Tolentino is now a businesswoman and based in Dau, Mabalacat, Pampanga. Next is Miss Juliet Tobias, now Mrs. Sayo, and currently working at San Lazaro Hospital. We also have Miss Tomasa Tomato, also known as May, and now she's retired and from Tabuk, Kalinga. We also have Miss Demetria Asena, now Mrs. Cowis, married, blessed with 4 children and 5 grandchildren, and a nurse at Bugyas, a local government unit in Benguet, nearing to retire, resides in Abatan, Bugyas, Benguet. Next is Miss Lydia Domingo, now Mrs. Bosman. She's from Akop, Tublay, and working as a PHN. And we also have Miss Esteria Uglayon from the Trinidad Benguet, and now a businesswoman. I'd like also to acknowledge the non-attendees, but who gave their support to this batch reunion. We have Miss Lorna Angala, Now Mrs. Dulay, she is married to Silverio Dulay from Manawag, Pangasinan, and based in Leeds, United Kingdom. Ms. Raquel Buangan, now Mrs. Chavez, presently working in Al Asha, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for 28 years and blessed with 4 children and 5 grandchildren. We also have Ms. Anselma Compalas, who's residing in Baguio. Unfortunately, she won't be able to make it tonight. We also have Ms. Carolina Gakusan, now Mrs. Manara. She's based in USA since 1979 and connected in Mayo Clinic. We also have Ms. Leonida Florendo, now Mrs. Kirol, and lives and works in Honolulu, Hawaii, USA. And we have Mr. Edwin Jovellanos. He's the Director of Nursing Perioperative Services of University Hospital in Brooklyn, Long Island. We also have Ms. Anselma Compalas. She's residing in Baguio, okay? And also, we have the guest classmates of Batch 1978. The guest classmates of Batch 1978 like to acknowledge Ms. Esther Suma, now Mrs. Zulueta, and she is now based in the United States. Also, Ms. Nenita Cuenco, now Mrs. Kiambao, and resides in Angeles, Pampanga. And Ms. Maria Luisa Manara, who lives now in Tarlac.
Let's all pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord God, for life. Thank you, Lord, for joy and peace, and even our fellowship and our batch mates before when we were studying at BCDHSN. Thank you, Lord, for everyone who is present here, Lord God. May we always have this love for them. May we always cherish each one of us. And may we enjoy and our lives today, and we be ready as you call us back home. Thank you, Lord. You may be glorified, be magnified today. In Jesus' name, amen.
I say amen to that. 5 days ago, we remembered and celebrated Resurrection Sunday. That was that day Jesus Christ rose from death and spent another 40 days on earth with his disciples, commanding them to make him known to the world. On the 40th day, he ascended to heaven. Similarly, when we parted ways 40 years ago, after graduation, to each his own, we began our own stories of success and failures. Today, thanks to FB, we are opportune to share the story God has hidden for us. Today indeed is a celebration. Let us pray. God, our Father, you are sovereign, you are loving, you are wise. Thank you for gathering us today as we celebrate 40 years of your faithfulness in our lives. As we share our stories to our classmates, open our ears that we can listen attentively and learn from life's lesson. Father, we ask you to bless this gathering with your presence and protect us from any untoward incident. May you be glorified in our needs. After all, life is all about you. And when we part ways again to move on to another phase of our life, may we have a renewed spirit of giving back to you through worship and service now that we have reached our retirement age. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
To be here with you and to enjoy the 40 years, to welcome everybody. It's an honor and privilege to have her here with us. I believe she was a former teacher of Pines City Doctors Hospital School of Nursing. Please welcome Ms. Violi Aplose.
Good evening to everyone. Well, the first thing that I would say is I should not be one welcoming you, but you are also welcoming me. So let's have this night a welcoming of everyone. Okay? So, I was there in Pines and now I could see that I couldn't remember the faces, you know. We have all changed. Okay, we became young, actually. All of us are very young at our ages. Yes. Since you've been, well, I have to welcome you for this 40th alumni homecoming in 1978. Because I left in Pine City Doctors Hospital in 1979, work abroad also, and just retired in 13th of October as a charge nurse in Military Hospital of Riyadh, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. So I know that I've seen most of you who became professionals, and this is a good sign that Pines really was a good institution. That's where you came from. And congratulations to every one of you, because all of you are professionals, successful in life. And this is what we had been praying to God before, right? And each one are having good families. Okay, each one of you are having grandchildren. And the others who are yet to retire, welcome later. But those who are retired, what shall we do? Let's enjoy the life of being seniors. As seniors, as what they say, that our life is just starting. So let's welcome everyone. Let's have our camaraderie. Okay, talk to each other, because I know that each of you also have already forgotten the faces of your classmates. So let's now have a good bonding and camaraderie. Good evening, and let's enjoy the night.
Thank you very much, Mom Violi. Applause.
Everybody!
You may move forward if you want. Here we go. Just follow our dance master. Yep. Come on. is the retro master, Richard Sway. Thank you very much. Okay. Sino may sabi ng senior hindi marunong sumayaw, di ba? Each other that was once firmed up in your alma mater. Be grateful for that. And now, after 40 years, you are here to look back from where you have started with so much joy and thanksgiving. You will experience that many things have changed. Familiar places and familiar people are gone. It has been 40 years. So what are you celebrating after 40 years? Is it only a reunion? Coming together, meeting once again former classmates and old acquaintances, renewing friendships, mesmerizing the beautiful experiences of the past. Don't forget that first and foremost you are here, together, to thank God for all His love and abundant blessings, His never-ending care and guidance for what you have become, for all your achievements and successes, but also thank God for your failures, because it was through your falls that you have learned the great lessons in life. You have journeyed long. Some of you have built your destiny, achieved your goal, but not without having overcome great obstacles. Now that you will never get to where you want to go without pains, without struggles, and without hard work. God was always with you. Life is not a bed of roses. Friends, my beloved, this is now the time to count your blessings, to harvest what you have planted, and enjoy the fruits of labor. You now enjoy the love of family, of husband and wife, especially your children. God's gift of love to you. Some of you have retired from active life to care for your family, your children, and perhaps your aging parents. They need you. You have additional role to play. Play it well and be happy. To be happy, Pope Francis said, is to let live the creature that lives in each of us, free, joyful, and simple. It is to have maturity to be able to say, I made mistakes. It is to have the courage to say, I am sorry. It is to have the sensitivity to say, I need you. It is to have the ability to say, I love you. May your life become a garden of opportunities for happiness. And when you make mistake, or when you make a mistake, start all over again. For only then will you be in love with life. You will find that to be happy is not to have a perfect life, but use the tears to irrigate tolerance. Use your losses to train patience. Use your mistakes to sculpture serenity. Use pain to plaster pleasure. Use obstacles to open windows of intelligence. Never give up. Never give up on people who love you. Never give up on happiness, for life is a long, hazardous journey. And so, strive to be happy. Make each day a better day. Make yourself a better person each day, and make the world, your community, and your home a better place to live in. Thank you and good evening. Congratulations for your Ruby Jubilee celebration. Signed, Sister Agnesia Naval.
Always been so calm, so cool. No love.
again, the Babangas Best Group! So I hope you enjoyed our performance tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening.
Yes.
To everybody.
Good evening.
Ang saya siya, nakikita ko mga mukha niyo, parang bumalik ako noong 1975. But before I go on, I'd like to congratulate the organizers of this reunion. Actually, isipin niyo na kuha kayo lahat-lahat. Though hindi lahat inandito, pero at least nakikita ko, big group. I mean to say, an reunion like this, school reunion, kadalasan, in a class, wala kang makita mga ganyan. It's the whole year na nakikita mo na may tao na, at least may makita ka. It's so difficult to gather really people around you, to be once again celebrating yung mga kanila activities before. And try to reminisce of the past. And I'm supposed not to give an inspiration or two, but to talk to them. I need to give a welcome address, but the problem, but I came late. You know? Alam mo naman tayo. Ganyan palagi, nahuhuli. Okay? Because you know, it's a hospital work. Tumanda na tayo, I'm already 69. Okay? Okay. Hindi na kagaya noon na impronto pag ako'y nagsasalita. Kinakailang may kudi ko. Kasi kung wala ito, wala akong masabi. At saka kinakailang mag-antipara. Kasi hindi ko alam kung sasabihin ko. You know, it's my honor really to welcome you. Ito, welcome pa rin kaya skip to the curriculum, okay? To the 40th PCDH Nursing Class Reunion 1978. You come to talk about coming home, coming back. Pag nakarinig tayo ng ganoon, something exciting to hear, di ba, no? Just think of me going back, seeing my alma mater, seeing the people that I have been with, okay? Parang so excited talaga pag we talk about coming home and coming back. Kasi alam natin ang reunion or homecoming is the time to reminisce the past. Di ba, yun ang kadalasan, we reminisce the past. And revitalize our ties with one another, okay? So, yung pagka-reminis natin sa past, it would make us more closer. Just think of it, reviewing the past. We try to enjoy it and to think about it. We become more closer when it comes to this part of this years that has passed, okay? It was a wooden school. It was a wooden school run by a congregation of nuns headed by Sister Agnesia Labar. Okay, maalala pa ninyo? The ladies' dorm were nasa basement, ano?
Yes.
Diba? And yung mga lalaki, they were also at the basement of the hospital. Okay? Doon sila nakastay. Fortunately, we were also there, the basement of the hospital. Kaya narinig namin yung mga chismis ng mga lalaki doon. So, kasama kong nakikipag-discuss sa mga tungkol sa mga students si Dr. Halili, maalala niyo? Naging roommate ko yun, di ba? Roommate ko si Dr. Halili. I recall I was your anatomy teacher. Anatomy laboratory. Kasi ang alam kong lecture was Dr. Mayuga, God bless his soul, okay? And Dr. Manaluto. Maalala pa niyo si Dr. Manaluto? Okay. So, laboratory lang ako noon. Kaya lang, alam kong na-notice ninyo that my way of teaching and discipline was quite different from the other instructors. Diba? Napansin ninyo yun, okay? Probably it was because I was a fresh graduate from the College of Medicine din. Kaya, in fact, I didn't look at you as nursing students. I looked at you as medical students. And that was a different way. Kaya doon siguro ganun ka ganun ang how I run your class, no? Parang it is like a finishing school.
Yes.
If you have seen movies, ano tapos sa finishing school, parang gano'n ang nangyari. Okay? Kaya, I seem to be, sa tingin ninyo, at saka maraming nag-isip na, I am a very non-approachable person. Rude. Sarcastic. Diba? Kadalasan sarcastic ang nasa isip niyo sa akin noon. Diba? Okay? So, alam ko yun. And probably lahat ng all negatives nandun sa akin, no? During that time. Alam kong pinaiyak ko kayo. Marami nang umiyak sa inyo when it comes to
sa
examination. Okay? Alam ko that everybody was tensive now and then I meet you on the hallway. Okay? Iba. even when you're in the third year, okay, ibang iba pa rin ang how we deal with each other. There was a distance that I usually presented, okay? Pero may mga things na also that comes in my mind. Unang-una yung sa anatomy. Alam mo, hindi ko makakalimutan ito. When I do practical exams sa anatomy, maalala niyo, lahat naninginig. Tuwang-tuwa naman ako. Okay? Makita kong nanginginig sila as they pass from one specimen to the other. Then mayroon isa sa inyo who intended or will touch the bone, okay? Nung during the time ng practical. Sumigaw ako nun, di ba? Don't touch the bone! Yan, karala niyan. Hindi ko alam kung sino yan eh. Hindi ko alam kung sino yan. Parang si, kung hindi si Wola, si ano, si Sai Marero. Ano na, ano? Naalala ninyo yan? Pagkatapos ng exams, eh, lahat yan umiyak na nagsasabit sa akin ng report. Yan ang results. Ang pinaka, I don't know, ang pinaka, how could I term it? Parang ano ba? Parang nandun ako sa tubato. Pagka pinuposti ko na ang examinations. Maalala ninyo? Bigla na lang may makita ko yung nakapost doon sa bulletin board. Makita mo lahat mo nakapasa? Yung hindi nakapasa, naka-mark red ba yung typewriter? Double space. At kung tuwa ko, nakikita ko umiyak kayo. At may naka-approach sa akin and said, definitely you have to. You have to give more hours for studying here. Marami na nag-approach na gano'n. Unfortunately, mukhang sinundan din ako ng mga iba kong co-faculty, di ba? May nag-post din sa microbiology, Dr. Carosa. Marami ninyo? Tsaka si Miss Luna. Ay, Dr. Carosa. Ed Carosa and Miss Luna. Okay. God bless her soul also. Okay. Pero ang one thing that made me happy what I've been doing to you is this. Unang-una, in your later part when I did, when you were my students in med-surg, malaki ang sa inyo ang nakaka-recall ng anatomy. Kaya hindi ako nahirapan masyado going back to anatomy and physiology dahil sa med-surg tayo noon. Okay? May event naman na nangyari sa med-surg na hindi ko makalimutan. Nag-i-explain ako na one time ng isang infectious process. Hindi talaga maalis ito. Infectious process. Tapos sinabi kong, if patient has fever, you give antipyretics. Okay. If the patient has chills, may sumigaw. Ay, hindi pa lang may sumigaw. Back doon sa akin. Ano yung sinabi ko? Give anti-chills. So yun ang mga things that I can recall, okay? But there's one very special event that I cannot forget. It is the scene of Madame Luna, Marlene, okay? In one of the patients with his son, I don't know how to love him. Narinig daw, kumanta siya kanina sa akin, hindi ko narinig. Sa nakakantay mo yung mga yan. The thing was, she was very emotional and passionate. Parang nakikita mo yung isang, parang bumalik sa akin na teaching, parang si Virgin Mary and Do, na kumakanta na I don't know how to love him. O kaya si Mary Magdalene. Pero kung kukunin mo ngayon, para siyang si Casey Tandina. Na kumanta ng Say Something. Nakikita din niya, kumakanta ng Say Something. So, alam kong iyon ng kanta na yun was intended for one of your classmates. Alam kong alam ninyo kung sino yun. Or sad events, okay? And it is but so nice for you to bring it out again this time after 40 years of being apart, di ba? Alam mo, you were very young then. Okay? Probably not mentally, emotionally stable. during those times. Okay? But you were so full of energy, so full of love. Okay? Yeah. Expression of love. Okay? But probably most of you didn't understand how life is. Not as of now, after the 4 years, siguro may naano ng yung klase kung ano talaga ang buhay. Hanaka ba kapag step ko rin? It's more happy, more closer. Because we could laugh it out now, and we could say that those days were days of growing up, which has been our part of our life. Okay? Again, I'd like to congratulate each and every one of you for being so passionate in coming over here, okay, and creating this reunion and be together once again. Okay? Alam kong nakikita ko dito po konti ang mga taga-Baguio actually. Okay? Pero marami kayo, marami sa inyo ang wala, hindi taga dito. And yet you give time and effort really coming up to be together. That's one thing that I salute you on, okay? Sa ganung attitude niyo. I hope this reunion that you're having, okay, would grow on, and I hope the others would join you in the future.
Thank you very much, Dr. George Pangui. So the feeling is normal when it comes to anatomy and physiology. Now I know. Ninervous din po sa anafisyo namin. Okay, thank you very much for those inspired words of welcome. And now, may we request everybody to please rise. Let's all stand as we have our group singing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Please welcome to give their dance presentation. We have the Ruby Jubilarians from Baguio Benguet's finest.
Woo!
for generously sharing your blessing. We are indeed grateful. Alam naman ninyo, kung walang fans, hirap kumilos. Again, maraming salamat sa inyong lahat. To our dear batchmate who sent messages of encouragement and kept us inspired, we will never forget your kind words. Thank you. God bless you. To the Baguio Benguet organizers, you know who you are. For the unwavering dedication, time, and effort. May kasama pang sleepless nights. Down. Sweat and tears. Siguro tears of joy. We truly appreciate all that you have done for the success of this 48-year reunion. Let us give the organizers a big round of applause. To Ruel, Elizabeth Sebastian, and company for our AVP, photo booth, and video. Thank you so much. Special thanks to the Soriano family for accommodating us for our meeting and practices. We feel the love. To our chairman, Vicky Mamaison, who put her heart into this. Maraming salamat. To the hubby, Mr. Lito Soriano, siyempre awa dito din, our very supportive advisor. You are one of our blessing. Thank you. To Anne, with this multi-talented builder, who contributed too much for the success of this special occasion. Thank you for Ralph Jr. for taking time to drive us around to make our errands and tasks easier and comfortable. Oh, by the way, we will surely miss the eat all you can and overflowing coffee at your one home, Sorianos. May God bless you more. Thank you from the bottom of our heart. To our guest performers who gave their time and effort and shared their God-given talents, maraming salamat. You made this evening unforgettable. We acknowledge the presence of our special guest, Sherwin Martin, the flutist. Roe Blessing, our pianist, D.I. Richard Sway. You can always join him in her Zumba class. And DJ Riku Jan, Big Sound FM. You can Joyce Camille and Julian. Thank you for celebrating with us. Lastly, I thank the chalet management and staff for their kindness and understanding. A special thank you goes to Sir Sam, who is always accommodating sa mga makukulit na seniors. More power to you, sir. To make sure that I covered everybody, I would like to say thank you again to everyone who contributed in one way or another, present or absent, for the success of this 48th reunion. It has been a blessed 40 years. Let us continue to thank God and celebrate this goodness and faithfulness. Salamat po.
Alright? And also, we have one more special award, and that is the best or the star dancer. And our judge, the retro master himself, Sir Richard Sway. May we have the result, please? Do you have the result? Yes, alright. So, who is the star dancer for tonight? Sir Alex Martin. Congratulations, Sir Alex. May we have you here in front, please? Sir, you will be wearing that all night long, okay? Sir, please.
Ang nag-iisa.
Ang nag-iisa daw, sir. How about a big hand for Sir Alex, ladies and gentlemen?
Face the camera, fire, Alex. Alex, face the camera.
Alright, okay, sir, Mr. Alex, face the camera.
Gabi po sa inyong lahat. Sa totoo lang po, I was not supposed to be the one standing here, but the one who was assigned, Mr. Edwin Jovindianos, unfortunately didn't make it home. Kaya inatasan akong mag-replace sa kanya. I tried many times to make a closing remarks, but according to him, but it's so long. But I'll try my best. Ito, sabi ni Edwin. Mayroon akong isang tanong. How many bones are there in a human body? Of course, pinaalala ni Doc kanina ang kanyang class. Everybody remembers the Terror Anatomy class of Dr. Bangui. Marami siyang pinahiyang. But you know what? The class was really so intense. Very challenging and very competitive. Di ba, Doc? And also he mentioned that he posted the grades, our grades test scores in a bulletin sa para makita ng lahat. Kaya siguro maraming nangyayari. But you know, if you come to think of it, it was really a brilliant, a good idea 4 years ago. Because it has made us more focused and study harder. And no wonder, maybe, you know, for the class of 1978, we made history of making a 100% passing rate in the nursing writing program. Congratulations, Ate. Siguro, that's one of these achievements that we have done. And going back to the audiovisuals, you know, after watching those pictures of our young selves, nakikita ko na aming natutuwa. It was such a joy to remember our long-forgotten classmates. Marami pong gumalit na alaala, memories, and recollections of the many things that we've shared 40 years ago. Hindi lang po tayo ang nagbago. Not only us have changed, but the world around us. Take for example, our school. In our time, we used to call it Pine City Doctors Hospital School of Nursing. I think with only 2 curriculum courses, midwifery and nursing. But right now, the school and the hospital has gotten so big. Tanungin niyo po si Doc. It is now called Pine City Colleges with multiple courses or medical related courses like dentistry, physical therapy, and optometry, and all related medical courses. And the once neophyte instructor that we have before is now the medical director. Ang galing niyo po Doc.
Thank you.
Thank you.